yours to be the last face I see at night, because if I die during the night, I will die with the happiness of my mother's face in my heart. Her life was cut short. The lives of those two young girls whose mother was killed, their future, there is a question mark. What was the crime of these people? What was their crime that they should have faced the police bullet? My dear friends, today from this platform, when we raise the question, who is responsible for this situation? Who is responsible for the fact that in village after village, there is no water which is fit to drink? In village after village, people's health is affected. In village after village, the land cannot be used for agriculture because of the pollution which is there, because of the hazardous practices of the Sterlite copper plant.
There are laws in this country. There are laws about the protection of environment in this country. How is it that this company was able to break all the laws? Whose support did they have? We know that in February this year, it was the Modi government sitting in Delhi who gave the license and green signal to this polluting company to go in for a double expansion of its work. Is it possible that without any monitoring, without any audit, without any social impact assessment, the central government should allow the expansion of a polluting plant? My dear friends, the question is, how was the plant's expansion allowed? A few years ago, the Supreme Court had fined this company 100 crore rupees because it was defying and violating the environmental laws of India. But without checking, without any check, the government gave the green signal for the expansion of this plant. This was an illegal action taken by the Modi government in its pro-corporate ease of business policy. You have heard of crony capitalism.
And
the records show that Vedanta first gave money to the Congress Party. And then, when Mr. Modi came to power, the Vedanta company gave a lot of money to the Modi Party. We call that party Bharatiya Jhagra Party. That means party which fights. You know, in Hindi, Janata, Bharatiya Janata Party is Bharatiya Jhagra Party. It is a fighting party. It fights with the people but is friends with its crony capitalists. So they got a big donation from Vedanta. It was an illegal donation at the time. But the government brought a law with retrospective effect to legalize the donation of Vedanta. And therefore I say, as far as the list of those responsible is concerned, the first number on the list is the Modi government sitting in Delhi. It is because of their policies that the license for the expansion of the plant was illegally given in Delhi and supported by the AIDMK government in Tamil Nadu. Unfortunately, today we see all the groups of AIDMK, they have come together and they are competing who will be closest to the Bharatiya Jhagra Party and Modi ji. This is the reality of the political situation in Tamil Nadu today. And therefore, my dear friends, when we raise the slogan of justice for the people of this town, for the people of this district, when we raise the slogan of justice against the practices of the Sterlite plant, at the same time, the framework of our struggle must be against the pro-corporate policies of the Modi government and the same policies being followed by the AIDMK government here in Tamil Nadu. My dear friends, unfortunately, the role of the administration here and the role of the police is highly questionable. For all these months, the administration did not move. When people's health was being affected, when people could not get water, when people could not till their land, the administration never moved. For 100 days, the people of that village were on a peaceful struggle, 100 days. But did anybody go and meet them? Did any minister go and meet them? Did any administrative official go and understand their plight? Why were their voices not heard? That is the question of a callous administration and a callous government. The people who came for the demonstration on 22nd May, who were they? They were the poor of the villages. They were women who came with their babies in their arms. There were women who brought their children with them, who brought their food packed in packages, because they said, we will sit peacefully at the collectorate till our demand is met. A woman who is bringing a baby in her arms and a senior citizen who is coming here, they are not people who want to indulge in violence. For 100 days they were sitting peacefully. And then, my dear friends, on 22nd May, there was the police firing in which 13 innocent people were killed. My dear friends, we saw the videos of people in uniform on the top of cars with their guns pointed at the crowd, shooting to kill. We are not for violence. We do not believe in violence. We do not believe in burning and beating. But the question is, who was responsible? And why is it when the FIRs have been filed, there is not a single FIR against the police for firing into the crowd and shooting to kill? So when we met the collector and the IG of police today, from our party, we have made the demand, we have made the request that if you have filed an open FIR against all people, why you have not filed any FIR against those who were responsible for the killing of 13 innocent people? That is the question that we have asked the administration today. My dear friends, when we went to the villages today, the women told us that last week, night after night, some people in plain clothes were going to the village and knocking at the door and breaking open into the house and asking for the whereabouts of this or that person. In one village, 7 to 75 women told us that they were so scared that they were sleeping the night in the temple. Why should the police, why should the male police go to the village at night? If you are looking for someone, if you are investigating a case, go during the daytime. Ask those people. They will cooperate. But going in plain clothes, going at night, this is totally and utterly illegal. It is against the law of the country. It is against the court injunctions. And it is against humanity to go to a village and terrorize women at night. But we were happy that the IG and the SP here, they heard us and they gave us a categorical assurance that they will inquire into the matter and ensure that such midnight raids in the villages will not take place. That assurance they have given us today. And I hope they will implement this, and through you, I would like to send a message to all the villagers and especially to the women who were affected. Be brave and courageous. If any such complaint happens, immediately contact our party. The red flag will be there with you in your struggle against such illegal actions if they take place. My dear friends, when we ask the villagers, what is it you want us to do? What is the demand that you have before the administration? And not just the villagers. We asked the husband of Jhansi, who was shot dead. We asked him, tell us, brother, what is it that you want? What is it that you want this government to do? You see what he said. He did not ask anything for himself. He did not ask anything for his family. He did not ask anything for his daughters. What did he say? He said, I want only one guarantee, the permanent closure of this copper plant, which has destroyed our lives, our health, our land. My dear friends, as communists, as representatives of the working class and the poor, we don't usually demand the closure of an industrial unit. We want more factories, we want more industry, we want more employment. But this company is a company which has destroyed lives. This is a company which has violated every environmental law in this country. This is a company which has refused to give employment to local people. This is a company where the large majority of workers are contract workers with not even minimum wages. This is a company which does not add anything to the lives of the people in this region. This is a company which has destroyed lives. It has destroyed health. It has destroyed land. And therefore, the CPIM has strongly supported the demand for the permanent closure of this company. So we support this struggle, we support the demand. At the same time, we have told the administration, what has happened to the 100 crore rupees which the company paid as a fine on the mandate of the Supreme Court? Where is that money? Who has used the money? Who has it helped? We asked the collector, we asked the IG, and what was the answer? It is not 5 rupees or 10 rupees. 100 crore rupees. But they don't know where the money has gone. They could not give any answer. We said we understand. The collector has only come now. When he said, I cannot answer for my predecessor. He cannot answer. But the AIDMK government has to answer. The government sitting in Chennai has to answer. Where is that 100 crore rupees? Who was it spent on? As far as we know, what the people of the village told us, it was not spent for the village. Mr. Modi talks about made in India. Today I saw a new machine that is made in Thoothukudi. Do you know what it is? It is like a cycle in which there are 6 iron rings. What are those iron rings for? Because the women say, we cannot carry so much water at one time. The water in our village has become brown because of the copper sulfate. The water in our village is undrinkable. We have to go very far to get water. Therefore, especially in Thoothukudi villages, in every house, there is a made-in-the-village machine in which at one time, women can bring 6 buckets of water. I told the collector, we have brought a gift for you. What is that gift? A bottle of water of the village near the plant, which is brown in color. That 100 crore rupees, if it had been spent to help the end of pollution, to ensure drinking water for the villages, how much it would have helped the women of that village. But this is the callousness of this government, that till date the money has not been properly used. Therefore, my dear friends, we made a demand that it is essential that the people of the villages must be consulted for how that money is to be used. And the collector gave us an assurance that from now on, the Gram Sabha and the people of the village will be consulted as to how that money is to be used. And the last point in our discussion which we had made, how many people have been arrested? Who are those who are in jail? Who are those against whom so many charges have been made? They are fisher people. They are agricultural workers. They belong to oppressed communities. They are working people who are fighting for a democratic right to live in a healthy environment. We have demanded that the false cases against all of them should be withdrawn. The SP told us that out of 245 who were arrested, except for 30 to 40, all the others are out on bail. But we know it is not enough to be out on bail because they are working people. We know how much harassment there is if they have to leave their work, keep going to court for appearances for a crime which they have not committed. And therefore, the demand for the release and the demand for the withdrawal of the cases is a very important demand that the CPIM has raised. At the same time, some young people have got arrested under the Black Act called the National Security Act. My dear friends, this is not a case of the security of the nation. This is not a case of the security of India. How is it that people who are protesting against the pollution and hazardous practice of a company should be arrested under the NSA? Under the NSA, there are such provisions that they cannot get bail. The charge sheet can be filed at a later stage, so they can be held indefinitely without charges filed against them. So what we say is, the Modi government has misused the National Security Act in case after case. Whenever the government is criticized, whenever the government policies are opposed, the NSA is used. And unfortunately, here in Tamil Nadu, following in the steps of the Big Brother. What is Big Brother in Tamil?
Periyanna
in Delhi. Following in steps, what is steps?
Periyanna valiye pinbatruvathu. Periyannan paadai.
Periyanna paadai. Following in the Periyanna paadai, the small brother sitting here in Tamil Nadu is misusing the same act to arrest people. This is not national security. It is for the security of the company that people are being jailed. We strongly protest against this. We condemn the use of NSA against agitators and protesters, and we demand the removal of NSA in the charges against them. We are very happy to hear that many lawyers of this town have supported those in struggle. We are proud that many of those in the Bar Council have decided that they will give their services free of charge to help those who are facing false charges. I congratulate the lawyers. This is a very important message of solidarity. It is a very important message of unity, and I congratulate them. I believe this is a message which will inspire others across the country for similar actions of solidarity. My dear friends, the CPIM, our understanding, our approach has been one right from the beginning of taking forward the struggle against this company. Comrade K.Kanagaraj is here. As the CITU president, many, many years ago, the first case against the company, he was one of the first fighters in the court against this company. Right from the beginning, the red flag has been with the struggle for justice. That is what the CPIM represents. That is the politics of the CPIM. Today, the economic policies of this government, which are bringing so many burdens on the people of India, and when the people fight,
They try to divide the people in the name of religion. We are happy and proud that in this struggle, whether they are Christians or Hindus, whether they are this caste or that caste, together the people have united to defeat this policy of division. And that is also an inspiring example for the rest of the country. We are proud of the struggle. We are proud of the unity. The CPIM stands firm in the support of people's unity. And I am sure in the coming days, we will achieve justice. We will achieve our aim in this struggle to ensure that those who have sacrificed their lives will always be remembered. Their sacrifice, my dear friends, will not be in vain as long as we fight, as long as the struggle for justice becomes strong. I thank you very much. Inkalab Zindabad, our struggle Zindabad.